Hey, how's it going, duty solfers? Today, as promised, I'm going to show you how you can undo the steering wheel lock on your car with or without a key.
All right, so first, let's say you have the key, but you either can't get it into your ignition, or when you can't turn it.
So if that's the case, you want to grab yourself some WD-40 and then apply a generous amount into the ignition lock cylinder. Word of caution, WD-40 does collect some dust and debris and it might gum up your ignition lock cylinder even further. So if you don't intend to replace this, I recommend using a product called TriFlow. And that's what locksmiths recommend when lubing up locks. So next, we put our key in the ignition
and then we grab the steering wheel and turn it to the left or to the right, depending which way it was turned to lock it. And then we turn the key back and forth as we try to unlock it. And if that doesn't work, you can rock it back and forth. Sometimes the vibration helps unlock it.
If that doesn't work, you want to grab yourself a small hammer
and then tap the end of the key as you're trying to turn it. And the idea behind this is to use the vibration caused by tapping with this hammer to loosen up the tumblers that are inside your ignition lock cylinder, therefore allowing you to turn the key.
Also, if you have a helper, get them to rock the steering wheel back and forth as you're tapping on the key and trying to turn it. If that doesn't work, what you want to do next is to pull out on the key a little bit, maybe a click.
And then what you want to do is to give it a good whack with your hammer. Make sure you hit it straight on, otherwise you're going to bend your key. And don't give up if this doesn't work at first. And you can try a couple times, slowly increasing the amount of force you use with the hammer.
And if that fails, well, you're just going to have to find a way to get your ignition lock cylinder out and replace it without the key. All right, first thing you can do is to get yourself a nice heavy-duty screwdriver and grab yourself a nice heavy hammer.
Then start hammering away until you can get the screwdriver all the way in or until you can get it to where you can turn the ignition lock cylinder inside here.
And next, once you can turn this, you want to get it to the accessory position. And then, depending on where your ignition lock cylinder is located, you either need to remove the kick panel, like on this car, or if it's on the steering column, you would need to remove these covers.
See, when you have the key and need to replace the ignition lock cylinder, you basically put it in here, put it in the accessory position, and that's the only position that allows you to press this pin in. And then with that pin pressed in, you just pull on your ignition lock cylinder assembly, and with some wiggling, you should be able to get it out.
There we go. So basically with the screwdriver, we're destroying all the insides of this ignition lock cylinder, but that's okay since we're gonna replace this anyway. All right, so let's say you weren't able to get your screwdriver all the way in there, or you simply weren't able to turn the ignition lock cylinder. Now, if you're lucky enough to have an ignition lock cylinder assembly that goes onto your steering column, like this one here, you can basically try to remove this top cap and then remove this assembly by undoing these two bolts. These are safety bolts, and basically the way you can remove these is to get a screwdriver and a hammer, put the screwdriver on the side of these and then hit it until you get these to move, and then once they're loose, they're easy to take out. Here's a look. So once you remove this, you can just take this whole assembly out, and here's a look at the lock that locks your steering wheel in place. See, on this setup with the key out, this is extended out, locking into place the shaft for your steering wheel, but when you put the key in and turn it, it goes back in, releasing the lock. Now, sometimes you don't have a separate assembly for your ignition lock cylinder, and the ignition lock cylinder simply goes into your steering column. And if that's the case, I recommend you try to drill this pin out. Just make sure you pick a small enough drill bit that's made for drilling metal, or even better yet, you can use deep bearing bits that they sell at your local auto parts store that you can either put on your drill or even a Dremel, and those work better than a drill bit. And once you drill that pin out, you can use a pick to get your ignition lock cylinder out. Or you can drive in a screw in there and then use a pair of pliers to pull it out. By the way, when you get your ignition lock cylinder out, you can just use a pair of pliers or a screwdriver, depending on your setup, to turn that piece, which will turn your ignition switch and start and drive your car. But you should go without saying that you want to replace that ignition lock cylinder with a new set, because otherwise anyone can just jump in your car and get it started and drive away. And if for whatever reason that fails, well, you have no choice then to start drilling into your ignition lock cylinder. You want to start off with smaller bits and work your way up until you can turn this ignition lock cylinder at least to the accessory position and then push in that pin and then remove it. Now, I recommend you look into your repair manual first though, because sometimes they give you an exact spot on this where you can drill into, and then that will allow you to remove this ignition lock cylinder. Because otherwise, you're gonna have to work your way up from a small drill bit and basically drill out enough of the inside of this until you can remove it. And one last thing, if the key for your car comes with a chip inside, then this procedure will work, but then you're gonna have to find someone to program that key to work with your car.
And that's all there is to it, folks. If you found anything useful in this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you want to see more like it, but also consider checking out some of my other videos. I'll put it up on this side of the screen as video links so you can click on it. And if you have more time, check out my support page. I put a link to that right below this video and also in the description box, and you can have a say in what videos I make, plus some other perks there. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.